Game on. Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Ardent, rule the water.
Now that's why they call me the extreme.
Strike King Lure Company, gearing up champions for over 40 years. This week on Extreme Angler TV.
So I can put this bait in the nastiest of weeds and still feel confident I'm gonna pull those fish out.
Probably one of the best vegetation techniques I've ever seen is just throwing a swim jig and just working it back.
We'll be right back.
Well, Mr. Walleye, hey, welcome back to another Extreme Angler TV. You know what? This week, it's about a week and a half away from bass season, and I gotta get out. I gotta go fishing and stuff, man. I'm gonna go chase some walleyes, and what am I gonna do? Maybe jerk bait, creature bait, but one of my favorite ways to catch walleyes is hair jig, ripping. You know I'm a power fisherman. I love to throw the big stuff, the heavy stuff, into the real nasty stuff, but in this case, it's gonna be the good old hair jig, okay? I'm gonna throw that on some light braid with 6'3", 6' rods, and I'm just gonna dissect it. And what am I gonna do here? I'm gonna fish with the hair jig. I can fish fast, yet efficiently. I can rip it, let it drop. I wanna find those active walleyes. They predicted to be a real hot day today, and I'm just gonna show you can still catch them if you find them and use the right baits in the right spots. So I'm gonna fish those outside weed lines and the very tip of the inside weed lines, anticipating those fish are eating at nighttime and just cruising around. But as the sun gets higher, I get closer to that heavier weed. So sit back, relax, let me throw my hair jig around a bit, get anticipation for bass season in about 2 weeks, and catch some walleyes with my little power bait called the hair jig. I talk about variety, man. You gotta be prepared. I'm fishing anywhere from about 7 feet to about 12. So I'll use a little 1/8 ounce, 3/16, 1/4 ounce, but I like the smaller jigs. Smaller jig for walleyes, they just inhale. So I got a good variety, different sizes, and two basic colors. Black and red, and my favorite, black and yellow, black and yellow. Now the polymer, bend it over, just like that. Put it through the hook eye like that. Once around like a granny knot, or shoelace knot, and down just like that. You get the loop, very simple. Put it around your bait like that, bring it up, find the tag end, and just pull it like that. You wanna make sure it just sits just nice and straight, and that's it. Simple, simple stuff. I gotta be close to those weeds. Let's see what's feeding out here first thing in the morning. See what wants to eat. Get close to the weed, close to the edge, we're gonna catch fish. It's not rocket science, it's walleye fishing. I'm putting this bait in a spot that I know walleyes are cruising in. Just a matter of finding the right location and where they are. In a thicker weed, outside edges, first breaks. That's why I use a reaction bait first thing in the morning. I can throw that grub around, and you've seen other shows where I got them in the grub first thing. The weed was a bit more sparse, so the walleyes could see that bait just bouncing off the bottom, etc. Now the weed is just like a wall. So they'll hug tight to it, go out and feed, go around the edges. But I'm gonna find those aggressive fish with the reaction bait, which is the hair jig, first thing. You wanna find the most aggressive fish, the hair jig is a great choice. I am right in the lion's den, right here. right now. Like that. See the meat? That's what I mean. Big old fat walleyes. Ain't the big fat one I was looking for. But you see what I'm talking about? I just change up from the red to the chartreuse, and right away, right in the top of the gullet, first fish in the morning. Say hello, Mr. Walleye. Now, it just goes to show you, let's let him go. Look how chunky he is. Fat little thing. We got some big guys. I'm sure they're gonna be big on the feed, man, and real nice and fat. But that's the thing, you know, looking around, find the right locations. Now you're using hair jigs like that. I got the 20 pound spider thread braid. Check the point, always. I always put a nice little edge on those because, you know, you get through the little hard cartilage and bone, teeth and stuff. You can put a small barb on there. And with this presentation, when you're ripping like that, a lot of times you don't have a second opportunity to set again. You want that first set to make sure it finds its mark. If it doesn't, fish will shake, you'll lose it. You'll wonder why. Check your baits, check your lines, make sure your drags are always set. I got it fairly tight. I tighten it right down so the line barely comes out. If the fish has got some size, I'll loosen off, let them pull a bit. You'd be surprised how good these walleyes fight when you just got the right rod, reel, 20 pound test and braid, and a little bucktail jig. Now one thing you gotta remember with the hair jig, you're thinking, okay, he's gonna fish fast. Maybe those walleyes are subtle. Well, you know what? The temperature's in the low 70s now, about 68, 70 degrees. They are active. They're finished all their spawning and all that stuff. They just wanna eat, put back on that size that they had last year. So I'm gonna fish efficiently, but quickly. I'm gonna go in those areas, trolling motor on moderate speed. But when I'm at waypoints or in areas that I feel that are really good high potential spots, like points in the weed, inside bends of the weed line, outside bends, I'll slow it down a bit, make repeated casts, come from different angles and throw that bucktail in the same spots. I'll vary it, rip it hard, or sometimes just a little pop. So a lot of times I'm just underhand pitch, 25, 30 feet ahead of the boat, not far. I watch the bow and the line. When it stops, when it lays on the surface, little twitch. Watch the line go down, little twitch. I reel in the slack and I'm watching at all times. I do not take my eyes off that line. I got a really good sensitive St. Croix. The Arden's got a nice strong drag and I got 20 pound spider thread. It's soft, subtle, but real strong. So I can put this bait in the nastiest of weeds and still feel confident I'm gonna pull those fish out. Right there. See? He nabbed it right there. He ain't big, but he came out of those weeds. Just a nice eaten size walleye, eh? See what I mean about search and destroy? I've gotten about 45 minutes now, two fish. And they're almost like twins, aren't you? Aren't you? Wow. Let's let them go. Hey, look at you, hey? But again, we're looking for big fish today, you know? And I wanted to come out, it's about, oh, I'd say 10 days before bass season here in Ontario. But it's perfect weather, and some guys might say, well, it's not perfect walleye weather. You like a little bit of chop and overcast and stuff, but you know what? The fish gotta eat. And if you put the right baits in the right spots, you're gonna get bit. For now, I gotta go right inside the weeds. And nothing better than a nice, slender head, profile bucktail. It's a little bait, goes right into their kitchen. When they see it, they make an attempt, and either they eat it out of aggression or because they just want to eat it because it looks like food. Let's hopefully get a good one. So small underhand pitches, not far. I want to fish those areas that I'm finding on my sonar, and the you know, if I just went in and threw in a big weed bed, chances are you're going to catch fish. Okay, if there's enough walleyes around, everyone will. But if you dissect it and hit the pinpoint spots you find on your sonar, you'll catch more and sometimes bigger walleyes. He was right on that edge of that weed. Not that one. That's a better fish. Look, ripping out the weed. Look. Ripping him out. Nice fat walleye. Look at him. Hey? That's what I'm talking about right there. Look at him. There we go. See? Take your time. You catch Mr. Golden. And look where he got that to. Right on that bucktail. So grab those pliers. Grab the pliers. You bend the hook out like that. It's safe. Now that's a nice looking fish. I could feel when I was pulling him out of the weeds, look how golden yellow he is. You can tell he's sitting in that weed. But that's the key, putting the right bait in the right spots. What do you think, walleye? I'm gonna go back? Look how chunky they're getting. Oh, beautiful eating size fish. But we're here for some fun. You ready? Huh? See how healthy? See what I mean? Moving around, I've been fishing for about 45 minutes now. Went to one of my good spots. One fish, got bit off, could have been a big walleye. I think it was a muskie. But I moved around about 200 yards, start pitching. Put the focus, pull the hat down, focus. Pitch out, down. Got one fish, got another fish back to back. I'm gonna check my lines and hopefully catch one more real good one here. And if it starts to slow down, gut check time. Do I stay, do I go? If I keep catching or I miss fish, I'm gonna stay. If I go about 15, 20 minutes on productive areas I don't catch, I'm gonna move. Okay, here's something to consider, okay? Going down this weed line about, I'd say 15, 20 minutes, okay? Zigzagging in and out. I went to some waypoints that I've caught fish in the past. All of a sudden, two fish and about four casts. What do? Keep going to similar looking stuff? I did that for about 20 yards. Now I'm gonna turn the boat around, go back over the same areas I just caught two fish, thinking there's gotta be more around. Let's see. I fished now about an hour plus and tried a couple good weed lines, edges and stuff. Seems that the fish are a lot thicker than I thought they'd be. Again, preconceived notions. You go to those areas where you think that they may be on the edges and stuff. Yeah, they're in the edge, but 6 feet in the edge. Instead of that 10, 11, 12 foot of water with the weed, they're right in 8 and 9. So I got a few of the spots like that. I'm gonna move around. The wind's picking up a little bit. The temperatures are getting high. Then I'm gonna take this off so I'm a bit more comfortable. Go to another spot, see if we can repeat the same things that happened a little bit earlier with the hair jig. Okay, new spot. I'm gonna fish a little bit heavier, okay? I got the first couple fish that were real thick. So that, you gotta learn from that kind of stuff. Don't just go to guaranteed spots that you've caught fish in the past and think, okay, I've caught them out here before and stuff. Was it raining? Was it overcast? Was it windy? Use all those things into your mindset. Remember where you're fishing, remember the conditions. But what I've got so far today is I've gone to proven areas a little bit deeper, nothing. I missed one fish, could have been a muskie even. I came a bit thicker. I was fishing out in 10, 11 weed, sparse stuff, came into 8, boom, 1, 2, 3 fish. And you know what? I'm not a rocket scientist, I'm a fisherman, but I know too, go where the fish are. Cover water quickly, find the aggressive fish, and hopefully keep catching those walleyes. Let's see. You always gotta watch your sonar. Always watch where you are. That's why I make those shorter pitches. I'm looking at where I see the weed starting, so I got a good relation of how deep and where they get really thick. And I want that jig, especially with this high sun, to fall in those spots that are just a little bit thicker than the sparse stuff. But with the bucktail, you gotta look ahead, see where the weed is, be as close as you can to that weed, clumps, edges, weed line, whatever it is, watch it, underhand pitches, put that jig ahead. Sometimes you can move the boat to the left, to the right. If the weed line goes to the left, move out a bit, put some pitches into the right. If it cuts into the right, same thing. You follow your sonar, look where it is, look where the weed's the thickest, and then come out, make casts about 5 or 6 feet in, along the edge, on the drop. You cover that much area, you're gonna catch way more fish because you're more efficient. I'm praying it happens here. A nice big one. First one, that feels good too. Oh yeah, that's a good one. That feels good. Look at them pull. You can just tell when they got better walleyes, eh? Look at that. Wow, eh? 11 feet of water. How big are you? Oh, he's down there. Just a nice, solid little fish, eh? Look at him. That's what I came for right there, see? Good old bucktail walleye. Nice, fat-headed fish. Look at him. Oh, look at that. See how that spit out? Look at that. There's the bucktail. That's the importance of keeping solid weight on your bait, man. And that's what I mean right there, see? It's a nice, chunky, Kawartha walleye on the bucktail. Doesn't matter how sunny it is. Look how calm it is too. You put it in the right spots, ding, zippo, you're gonna catch him. Let's let him go. Come here, you. Hold him under his belly. Look how nice he is, beautiful, eh? Look how white there it is. Gorgeous looking fish. Looks like they've been just painted by a taxidermist. You ready to go? Huh? And the biggest thing you gotta remember is you're looking for a reaction strike. You know, you look out and say, man, it's pretty slick. I don't know if those walleyes are gonna be interested or they're gonna be somewhat dormant. Yeah, they could be a little dormant. Yes, it could be in the thicker weed, but using the bucktail with this presentation of snapping it and ripping it, all you're doing sometimes is just getting a reaction bite. Sure, you'll get those fish that are still aggressive in those kind of weeds because they all don't eat at the same time. You know what? You and I eat the same time of the day, we change it up. Same with the walleyes. So find those fish that are aggressive in that weed, but you can provoke the ones that are not aggressively feeding with the hair jigs in the heavy weed by putting it close to them, ripping it, and getting that reaction strike. It's a deadly, deadly presentation. And it's very important. Take the weeds off your bait. Otherwise, you can just shake them off. If they don't come off, pull them off. Pay attention to your hooks. Watch your sonar. Watch where the weed goes. Follow it. But don't make those long casts. Follow where you're fishing. If you see something on your sonar like that, you want to make sure your bait's either in that spot or going in that spot. It's very important, especially with the hair jigs. Like I said before, if it was a high, choppy day with lots of rain and overcast and stuff, those fish will be out roaming around. It doesn't really matter. You don't have to be as precise. But days like today, if you want to keep catching them on the hair, you got to be precise and put it right in those spots where you feel they're sitting. Told you. I think it's a good one too. Oh, just another good chunker. Look at them, look at them scrap. But I'm gonna show you something here. Give you an idea how they miss it and why they miss it. Look, okay? Now that's as close as you can get sometimes to his yap, but it's not in his yap. He went down to look at it. He saw that bait go down. Okay, what happens is my jig's going down. I'm ripping it through the weeds, ripping it, getting their attention, okay? They see it go up, it goes down. When I rip, this is my jig. He's looking at it like this, trying to find it in the weeds. You rip, you get them. But those fish you gotta let go. It's not in the mouth. But it just shows you, reaction. You know, that fish came over, he saw the ripping motion, maybe like minnows taking off and stuff. They all get excited, they're like cats fish, you know? He came over, saw the jig, he went into the weeds, he couldn't find it. I ripped, I got him, let him go. I'm hoping that I can get one of those real big guys to see that same reaction of that bucktail in the weeds, decide to eat it and have a real good time. That's my goal today. Gonna keep going. I think it's a good one too. Oh yeah, nice walleye, look at that, eh? Look at that. Right where he should be too. Right on the edge of that little point there. On the hair, huh? Look at you. Just a good eaten sized fish. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Came out, horn to throat, some hair jigs, which I haven't done since last year. That's where you need them pliers. Find it, pop it out. But that's what I'm talking about. You know what? I never caught any giant fish today, so what? Sometimes you catch the big ones, sometimes you catch the nice ones. But it's all about finding them, putting it together, whether it be plastics, jerk baits, or today, the hair jigs. We just got some chunky fish, no big giant fish, the nice weed walleyes, only a couple hours from home. Just put him back, go on you. The next time you wanna go out early summer on your favorite lakes with weed, get out the hair jigs, rip them up, fish fast, but fish efficiently, and you'll catch them too. Listen, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV, maybe ripping hair jigs on the Kawartha Lakes. Snag Proof, the world's finest weedless lures. Fishoflage, for love of the sport. Daiichi, bleeding red hooks. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. And follow us on Facebook and Twitter.